Okay, so in the last video segment, we talked about what I called the nominal exchange rate. Now we're going to talk about exchange rates again, and we're going to talk about what's called the real exchange rate. And as you might guess, based upon the name, the real exchange rate is the one that we feel is more economically important, the one that we really care about. So the real exchange rate attempts to get at the following sort of question. Where is it cheaper to take a vacation? So, we know that prices in Japan are charged in yen, and prices in the US are charged in dollars, and prices in Mexico are charged in pesos. And if we want to compare prices, we need to do a sort of double comparison. We need to convert everything into a common currency and then compare numbers. So let's go ahead and make up a situation where a hotel room is 20,000 yen per night in Japan, and an equivalent hotel room is $100 a night in the US, and 500 pesos per night in Mexico. Now, with just that information alone, we don't know where it's cheaper to take a vacation. We also need to combine this with information on the nominal exchange rate. So these are the information on the prices in the different countries. Information on the nominal exchange rate, let's go ahead and say it's 100 yen per dollar and 10 pesos per dollar. So what you can see is that, well, 20,000 yen is 20,000 divided by 100, or $200. And if we go ahead and look at Mexico, it's what we're going to calculate the US price is 500 pesos over 10 pesos per dollar. And notice the pesos on the bottom and the pesos on the top would cancel out, and we would end up with 1/1 dollar as our unit of measurement on the bottom. And if it's on the bottom of the fraction, it would then come onto the top. So we would go ahead and see that the Mexican price would be equivalent to $50 per night. So the price of a hotel room in Japan is $200 per night. The price of a hotel room in Mexico is $50 per night. And we can see that it's cheaper to take our vacation in Mexico, leaving aside airfare, of course, and all that kind of stuff. So one way of looking at this is the real exchange rate is one hotel room, or one night in a hotel room in the US. With that same amount of money, I could get half of a hotel room in Japan. Or I could get two nights in a hotel room in Mexico. So, you know, if you've ever traveled internationally, you're kind of familiar with doing this kind of comparison in your head. You know, admission to a park or something like that costs a certain amount of euros or Canadian dollars or Mexican pesos or whatever. And then you sort of go, okay, what's that in, quote, real money? You know, U.S. money being real money. And you do that kind of comparison. And that works great as long as you're sort of comparing one good at a time. But we want to be able to compare the exchange rate overall for a whole country for all of its goods and try to figure out where is it more expensive to live life, in Mexico or Japan or the United States or whatever. So we're going to bring in a more formal definition of the real exchange rate. and the real exchange rate, which we're going to call big R, is the nominal exchange rate. So how many dollars, or how many pesos per dollar, how many yen per dollar, times the ratio of the price levels in the two countries. So the price level in the U.S. over the price level in the foreign country. And sometimes, you know, this could be called P, or, and the other one is sometimes called P star. Or instead of U.S., we might call it P sub D for domestic. But don't get too hung up on that. So the basic idea would be, if we went back to our previous data, we would go, what's the real exchange rate? The real exchange rate between U.S. and Japan is, well, the nominal exchange rate was 100 yen per dollar, and the price levels were $100 per night in the U.S. and 20,000 yen per night in Japan, and we'd get 100 times 100 on the top, which would be 10,000. And notice this yen symbol and that yen symbol would cancel out. This dollar symbol's on the bottom of the fraction, this one's on the top. So we get this kind of unitless measure here of 10,000 over 20,000, or 1/2. And that tells us, because it's less than 1, it tells us that the U.S. is cheaper. So what about the real exchange rate between the U.S. and Mexico? And in that case, we have the nominal exchange rate as 10 pesos per dollar. The U.S. price was still $100. And the Mexican price was 500 pesos per night. And so we would get $1,000 on the top. 10 times 100 gives us 1,000. 500 on, excuse me, if I said $1,000, I just made a mistake, because again, of course, the dollar signs cancel out, as do the pesos. We get 1,000 over 500 equals 2. Our real exchange rate is 2, which tells us the U.S. is more expensive. So, in summary, if R is less than 1, the U.S. is cheaper. If R is greater than 1, the U.S. is more expensive. And you can see how the real exchange rate is the one that's going to most influence where people want to buy things. Because people don't just take the exchange rate into account, and they don't just take the price into account. They take all three things into account, the exchange rate and the relative prices. So the real exchange rate produces a summary there. When the real exchange rate goes up, then the U.S. gets more expensive. If the real exchange rate goes down, the U.S. gets cheaper. So the real exchange rate going up is typically going to mean net exports are going to fall, because the U.S. is getting more expensive relative to foreign destinations. And if the real exchange rate falls, that's going to mean net exports are going to typically rise, because the U.S. has gotten cheaper.